We've got to get rid of these gas guzzlers and switch to electric cars that plug into the land of rainbows and unicorns. Hi guys, Lissette here for DNews. Often called zero emissions vehicles, electric cars are surely better for the environment, right? Not so fast. Their entire life cycle, from manufacture to use to disposal, needs to be considered when determining their environmental impact. We can't just look at their tailpipes. So taking everything into consideration, are electric vehicles actually better for the environment than our old-timey cars? The Union of Concerned Scientists, or UCS, recently conducted a cradle-to-grave study to dig into this question, starting by comparing the manufacturing of battery electric and petrol cars and materials and resources used. They used a Tesla Model S and Nissan Leaf to represent battery electric vehicles, also known as BEVs, and comparable mid-size and full-size gasoline cars. They found that before they even hit the road, electric vehicles are actually responsible for about 1 ton more emissions than their traditional counterparts. Yes, that's a winning point for your gasoline-powered car. This is largely because of the BEV's lithium-ion batteries, which require the extraction of rare earth materials, often through drilling, just like with oil. Not a very eco-friendly activity. When it comes to disposing of BEVs, they don't seem to be any better than regular cars either. In fact, they may have a greater environmental impact because it's tricky to dispose of their lithium-ion batteries, but data here is lacking. Now, when on the road, BEVs don't emit CO2, but their batteries need to be charged from electricity that has to come from somewhere, and this somewhere might have a CO2 output of its own. A report based on 2009 national averages found that if the electricity is coming primarily from a country like India, where coal accounts for about 60% of electricity generated, your BEV ends up emitting CO2 at about the same levels as a 20-mile-per-gallon car. In the US, where the fuel sources are much cleaner, this figure only rose to 40 miles per gallon, which is basically the average for a really efficient petrol car. So at this point, you may be thinking, if electric cars pollute more when they're built, just about the same when they're junked, and their battery charges can pollute even more than an efficient gas car, then of course electric vehicles aren't greener. Figures from studies like this one are often cited to make the case against electric vehicles. But here's the thing. Since 2009, BEVs have become much more efficient, and while India has added more coal-powered plants, the US has not, opting instead for renewable sources. Looking at 2015 data, the UCS determined that BEVs in the US are now the equivalent of cars that go 68 miles per gallon. And in countries like Paraguay and Iceland, the electricity is so clean that a BEV there would be like having a car that goes more than 200 miles per gallon. Their electricity grids are powered by more water, wind, and solar energy than other countries. When it comes to emissions, BEVs here are many times better for the environment than petrol cars. What's more, the longer you drive an electric vehicle, the better it stacks up against gas vehicles. The UCS found that basically if you drive an EV for a month, you might as well buy a car. But drive that puppy for 2 years and you're helping the environment. All said and done, the UCS found that electric vehicles produced about 50% fewer emissions than a regular car in the US. Basically, the comparative environmental benefits increase the more you drive and the cleaner the electricity source. Now, we're of course only talking about global warming emissions. We're not saying that one type of car is categorically better than another. You might have a personal preference for other reasons. Maybe you're into salt-powered cars? To learn more about those guys, check out this episode here.
The Quant E Sport Limousine has two tanks of liquid with dissolved metallic salts that give them opposite charges. These are pumped through a membrane, and the process of recombining them generates electricity. Nanoflow Cell claims one fill-up is good for over 300 miles.
Now, if you're a fan of the biggest and baddest water creatures, you can watch the full season premiere of River Monsters online now. Just click the link in the video description below and catch new episodes of Season 8 every Thursday on Animal Planet. What's your favorite car? Do you prefer petrol, electric, hybrid, diesel, something else? Share your thoughts in the comments and remember to subscribe so you never miss an episode of DNews. Thanks for watching, guys.